Hi, this is Gregory Bufidis, the founder and chairman of Project Counsel. I'm here at the Langham Hotel for the Georgetown Corporate Counsel event. It's the first time that they've come to Europe and repeated the Corporate Counsel event, which has been going on in Washington, D.C. for approximately 14 years. I'm very happy today to have as my first guest Professor Mario Monti, who most of us remember as having served as a commissioner with the European Commission twice. First with internal markets and then with competition. And most of us remember him as initiating the investigation of Microsoft. Today he had a fabulous first presentation, keynote speech. And Professor, I want to go over some of the points you made. Thank you very much for joining us.
Pleasure.
You had mentioned the huge silent convergence. I was wondering if you might be able to summarize for us the points you made.
Sure. In the last 10 or 15 years, there was often discussion about divergences between the US and the European Union, politically or in terms of economic and regulatory policies. In reality, there has been a huge, silent, ongoing convergence. The European Union is now much more similar in its construction and identity to the US than it was the case 15 years ago. Just think of the following. 15 years ago, the US had been having for more than two centuries a single market, a single currency, had done their west-bound enlargement since a long time, and of course had a constitution since a long time. The European Union was lacking each of these four elements. And in the last 10, 15 years, it has built each of these four elements. Not really the Constitution. We have now the Lisbon Treaty in force since the beginning of this year.
Which is similar to a
Constitution. Which is similar to a Constitution. So it's amazing how much the European Union has, in a sense, upgraded itself in terms of institutional fabric and is now more similar, although still remaining very different from the US.
This morning you talked about several factors, what you called engines of economic growth that have propelled the EU. Can you talk about that?
The key engines were Germany and France since the late 50s when the common market was launched. That was really a project to gradually have Europe resemble more the market economy of Germany. France cooperated, Italy cooperated, the other founding members cooperated. Then, of course, in the mid-80s came on board with a big push the Margaret Thatcher-driven pro-market movement, the project about the single market. And now, for different reasons, in the last several years now, Germany and France have become less pushing on economic integration, a bit more introverted. The UK had continued to be an engine, but after the financial and economic crisis has, of course, its own domestic problems, and its ability to drive a European process has been somewhat tarnished, at least for the time being. So my view is that we need to find also new political engines for European integration, and I look with great hope at the new member states, Poland and many others, which have a culture which is still very much geared on markets, open markets, competition, and they could provide a stronger push now towards economic integration and therefore economic growth in Europe, which depends so much on the continuation of integration process. Nothing would be more dangerous for economic growth in Europe than starting a backtracking into disintegration.
I know that you're doing a special report for Mr. Barroso, and I know you can't tell us details or talk a lot about it, but can you give us an overview?
Essentially, it's a set of ideas on a new strategy to relaunch the single market, to move towards a real economic union in Europe. There will be in the report several proposals, many of them aiming at strengthening the single market and extending it to areas where it does not really exist so far, like the digital single market. And other proposals will be more geared on addressing some concerns, some of them social, others having to do with industrial policies that have come up in the last few years and have made for some disillusionment or some anxieties about the single market. We need to have a number of focused interventions to remove those concerns if we want to push ahead with the next big impulsion of progress in the European single market.
And this report will be due out, or is scheduled to be due out when?
By the end of this month, by the end of April, and then he will decide on the follow-up.
Excellent. Thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Pleasure. Thank you.
This is Greg Bufidis, the chairman and founder of Project Counsel. Thank you.